Good morning, everyone. We are doing something a little bit differently. So, normally we would be playing Aliens Fireteam Elite on Sundays, but we ended up finishing that this last Sunday. Don't mind the activate windows. By the way, I'm not using my normal computer, I'm using my side computer, the one that I normally use to do things like play guitar on, and also play indie games and a bunch of other stuff like emulators and old school games like what we were playing Moon Tycoon on. Just also real quickly, just to give a brief intro to those of you guys that are new, welcome to the Final Frontier of Funny. My friends call me Mac, the ladies call me Daddy. It's your boy Mac Daddy. Here we play
That's odd.
sci-fi, strategy, and scary. But as I was saying, normally we would be playing some Aliens Fireteam Elite, but since we finished that, we're kind of killing it today and the next Sunday until Aliens Dark Descent comes out, because then we're gonna start that. So I thought we would do something a little bit differently this Sunday and next Sunday. Keeping that one a surprise as well. So let's kind of get into this. Just a little bit of background. I've been playing Rocksmith for, I want to say, like 3 years now. Before getting Rocksmith, I had the hardest time learning to play any song. Any song. But the minute I got Rocksmith, easily, within like a week, no problem. Since then, it's been a really fun journey. If you want to seriously learn how to play guitar, a off-brand one, it may not work. I did have that happen to me at first. Also, shout out if you love Dance with the Dead like I do. Still good. I'm all like trying to turn up my volume, but for some reason, can't get it to turn up in my headset because I want to jam out. Now, I am playing bass guitar at the moment. One of the cool things that I do enjoy about Rocksmith is that. Okay, there we go. I was able to fix my audio there. So, even though mine is just a standard, like, six-string electric guitar, nothing too fancy either about it, you can play alternate roles on Rocksmith. You just gotta tune your guitar.
Masterful performance.
And as you guys saw, Rocksmith obviously helps. What do I want to jump into next? Let me see. Dance with the Dead sounds good at the moment. Although at the same time, there other ones in drop D that sound good? So, Rom lead. Ooh. I'm down. Just tweak the tuning slightly. Pretty sure I only need like my D and A string for Doom, if I remember correctly. I apologize if you guys get a little bit of feedback from like me actually plucking my strings and stuff. I'm gonna try and step back more. I can only go so far because I'm using a wired headset at the moment. Oh, what's I wanted to skip the tuner. This one's a good one if you're really into like music from video games and you're wanting to learn how to play guitar. Plus, it just sounds so good. Oh, I love Nick Gordon's music. That's a lot of the ones that I was first learning on here. It was just stuff from Doom. Oh, that one just feels so good every time you play it. Oh, you just feel the testosterone flowing on that. And when you let's go, 100% mastery. And when you crank that up to 11, oh my gosh, it feels good. Rammstein's always fun. I usually, like, when I'm playing, will try to stick within the same tuning before I switch things up. Just because it can get annoying sometimes trying to retune. I do like how Rocksmith sorts the tuning though, to where, like, say if you're going down the list of songs with how I have it sorted by tuning, if you're switching up your tuning, you move, like, say, to the tuning category right below it on the list, it's just a slight change. It's less of a change than if you were to go to the one below that. Does that make sense? I think one of my strings is slightly off. I think it's my A string. Because that's where I'm hitting that. Hey, I was right. It never hurts to double check when you're playing. It's better to catch it early on in the song than to go through most of it, because then you get a more accurate kind of picture of how you're playing. Alright, here, I'll shut up.
Ich will.
constant switching up back and forth. Oh my gosh, the guilty wrist after a minute. Woo! Oh, let's go though. 99. Oh! As I was mentioning how Mick Gordon and a lot of his songs from Doom are a good one to learn. Like, if you're trying to get started with guitar, I would say that some of the Rammstein ones are pretty good too. For sure. My favorites has to be Rammlied. That one's really good. If you guys haven't seen the music video of them live doing it, holy! If you've never seen a Rammstein video, definitely go check out the one for Rammlied. Oh my gosh. Another one that I would recommend is Ich tu der Weh. Because, oh my gosh, even if you don't understand a lick of German, and you've never taken classes like me and some other people might have, it's their energy, man. Like, they have just such a good energy. It gets you upbeat and pumped. It's really good to throw on, especially like if you're working out at the gym, for example. Oh, throwing on stuff like Rammstein is some of the best that you could throw on. But also, they are total showmen. They are 100% showmen. They go way over the top with their shows. And it's one of the reasons why I want to go to a Rammstein concert so bad. That would be so cool. Oh, whoops. I had myself muted, I think. Am I muted? No, okay. I'm dumb. I had myself muted there for a minute. I'm like, wait a minute. Why did the song skip ahead? Like, it skipped the cool intro of the chanting and stuff. Like, that's really thick, and it really gives you a good build-up. That's weird. I don't know why Rocksmith did that. I think it's because there's no guitar portion until a little bit later. I honestly hate this part. It's... Oh, I see where I messed up. My hand placement slightly off. Oh no. Oh, it's close. It's trying to stretch my pinky all the way to the 11. Thank you. Here we go. This is gonna get hype. Throw those horns in the chat. I had to actually play part of that from memory during that final solo. Freaking, I don't know why, but my screen keeps flashing. I guess it's probably because I'm using a slightly older PC on this game. It was flashing with static for just a fraction of a second. But for a moment there, during the final part of that, for like a whole second or two, it was just nothing but the static. So I'm like, I can hear it, and I know I'm playing it. And the game is still going, it's just on my screen. It was just static for a second. So I'm like, oh shit, trying to just go off of memory. I think it's just because Rocksmith doesn't like being streamed. I'm not sure. I'm just taking a guess. Shepherd of Fire is a fun one. Even though a lot of these say to play it, like, fingered, which I know that sounds wrong, that just means to play it with your fingers and not a pick. A lot of times, I still just prefer to use the pick. I don't really use my fingers much. Sometimes in songs, though, I'll, like, have my fingers, like, say my index finger that's underneath my pick. With how I'm holding it, with my thumb on top and my index finger on the bottom. Sometimes when I need to, like, pick super, super quick and manipulate multiple strings in certain ways, I'll use the tip of my index finger that's on the underside. I know it's a little tricky to explain at the moment. But if you were to just imagine, like, holding a guitar pick sideways, so it's, like, flat, your thumb is on top and your index finger is on the bottom, and you're using it like that, moving up and down. So I'll use my finger to kind of help me out with that at times. Alright, let's just jump right in. You guys grew up hearing this while playing COD Zombies, you're the real G's. Because that was the shit back in the day. Playing Origins, oh. Thank you.
Let's go. Nice. Going back on what I was talking about with Origins. Oh my gosh, Origins was one of my favorite COD Zombies maps of all time. Hands down. Sure, it was hard, but oh my gosh. The amount of work that they put into it. And the Easter egg was dope too. Like, it wasn't as convoluted as they are nowadays. It made sense. And it was actually fun trying to get the Easter egg. Want to change up my tuning, but I'm not sure. Not sure what to play. Tricky one. Tricky. Could play some Sabaton. Sabaton's a good one. Let me scroll up to East Standard. I know there's always some good stuff around here. Red Baron, that one's fun. Yes, let's go. This is closer to what I was looking for today. There we go. That's a lot better. Also, this is another artist that if you're not familiar with, I highly, highly recommend. that was lit. I felt good. Oh, 98%? You're kidding me. You're kidding me. Thinking something similar along those lines. Last is a good one. Ooh, I love this version of the Castlevania theme, Bloody Tears. That's another game that if you grew up on, I love you. Oh, my hand was starting to hurt by the end of that. Oh my gosh. Ow. Oh, 97 though. Exemplary performance. Pretty much matched my personal best. Okay, I can't complain too much there. At least I broke even. Would have been nicer if I got even higher game. BFG 10,000 is just insane. Oh, I recently learned BFG division though. I just had to tweak the settings on my guitar for a second. Let's get tuned. I'm only probably gonna need, like, yeah, these top three strings. Actually, EFG division. I think it only uses actually the A and the E now that I think about it. I don't even think it uses the A. Oh my gosh, this is going so low. Jeez, how low can you go? In all fairness, Mick Gordon does play on like a 9-string guitar and freaking, I think it's like, oh hell, what is it, like 8 octaves below standard tuning? Like some crazy, crazy shit like that. I forgot the exact number. But either way, I also love how it used sounds from like chainsaws and lawnmowers in making music. Yeah, I know I'm playing some really low notes. Oh yeah, this is gonna get metal. This is gonna be sick. Listen to how low this is. Oh my gosh, that is insane. Alright, this is my first time doing it on stream, so wish me luck. Should be fun though, I played it a few times. Anyone else want another Doom game? Let me know. That'd be sick. Also, we need to be playing those on stream. That'd be sick. Hold on a second, I think my string is slightly off. As I was mentioning before, in all fairness, I am trying to play on a 6-string, and Mick Gordon does play on a 9. I was right, it is off tune. I swear it's still off. Jeez, this is gonna drive me insane. Because I know I'm hitting it. I'm wondering if my distortion or something is too high on my guitar. Let me try flipping this around. Okay, that sounds better. Oh wait, hold up. It's trying to tune at the moment for a bent chord. Hold on a second. No wonder I'm probably getting it off. Is That's a lot better. That sounds better. Alright. That doesn't work. I'm gonna just say screw it at this point. That's the thing with note detection in this game, it's wonky. Yeah, it's the freaking bends. Sometimes when you're playing super low notes, like, or notes that are way outside of the range of what your guitar is supposed to be playing, the game has problems detecting it. So, for example, if I were to crank it up way high, it would have the same problem. Real question that I have for a lot of people that are really into Doom is which one they prefer, Doom or Doom Eternal? I know, it's such a tough one. One thing I do like that I think Eternal has over Doom 2016 is how they brought back the classic art style and a lot of the old school enemies, like for example the Arachnotron from Doom 2. Oh my gosh. Another Doom-related question that's a heatedly discussed argument is, what's your guys' favorite and least favorite enemies in Doom, though? I love my Arachnotrons and Barons of Hell. If I had to pick a least favorite, probably the Invoker, the one that summons stuff. The Marauder kind of sucks, too. And then maybe the Mancubus. They're kind of annoying. Oh yeah, this is my favorite part of the song. Let's go. Oh, I love doing that little move at the very end whenever I play songs. I think that's kind of becoming like my signature thing whenever I play songs. I'll yank up the end, well, obviously carefully so I don't damage my guitar. I'll yank up the end of it real quick and hit this really, 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 really low note. So it sounds almost like Godzilla. Not like that, but it sounds better like when I'm playing. Kind of like that. You gotta have fun while you're playing. You can't just be sitting there just like plucking away at the strings. You gotta have a little bit of fun with it, have a little bit of showmanship. I personally got hooked on, because when I first started out, I was sitting in my chair and stuff and having it on my lap. That's what I would recommend for most people. But then once you get more comfortable with it, maybe try experimenting, like try playing while standing up. And while you're at it, like you can start throwing in a little bit of dance moves, get a little bit of footwork in there, have a little bit of fun with it while you're playing. Because who says that learning an instrument has to be painful? Ooh, I say we play some Sabaton. That'd be fun. Ooh, yes. This one's an immediate win. Crank it all the way back up, though. Oh. Right about there. This one up. And then the other ones, I had E standard, so we gotta turn them down. And then I'll just leave it in this tuning, because I use this tuning like all the time. Oh my gosh, how'd that one get messed up? Maybe I just didn't have it right the first time? Come on. There we go. That one's too high still? Huh? How'd that happen? There we go. Oh my gosh. Crying out loud. I like how easy Rocksmith makes it, but it still doesn't make it any less tedious. Ugh. Sabaton's one of my favorite artists for sure. Like, they're definitely in my top five if I had to rank them. They're up there. Not just because of the overall energy and stuff that Sabaton brings to the table, but the history behind all their songs and how powerful they are. It's just so good. Play Wehrmacht. That's a tough one. I say we go for... Oh, crap. That's a tough one. Either Stormtroopers or Lion from the North. I think it's Stormtroopers. We'll do that, and then we'll probably start wrapping things up for the day. It's been pretty fun, though. This is nice to mix things up for once and change things up on the channel. Also, don't get to play guitar on stream often. Usually I'm just playing on Rocksmith by myself, just chilling. Anyways, let's jump right into it. Here, one split second. Let me just switch up my picks. This song, with how fast it goes, I need a more flexible pick. That's also a pro tip right there if you guys are learning guitar. Sometimes the thickness of your pick and how bendy it is can help. Like, a lot. Also, let me just double check that tuning real quick, because that felt slightly off. That's another one is, depending on if how hard you play guitar, you can... Yeah, that one was off. No wonder I wasn't picking it up. Depending on how hard you play, you can actually take it out of tuning in the middle of a song just by putting enough force on the strings. I have kind of a bad habit of doing that sometimes, if I'm being honest. It's probably not best for my strings, but at least they're dirt cheap. And you can buy them in packs of like freaking six sets, and it comes with a whole set of strings. You're not gonna believe this, that more flexible pick, I just broke it. No freaking way, I've never broken a pick. How do you break a pick? Like, I just broke the tip off my pick. How the hell did that happen? Yeah, it's like dulled and everything. My string's okay. Like, my guitar looks fine. I'm not seeing a scratch on it or any damage to the strings itself. That is so weird. I'm wondering if the pick is just old and the plastic's just worn out. Wow. Okay, so much for that. I'm gonna also try switching up the songs for a second. I'm wondering. I have a theory. Let me try Land from the North. And switch up the picks and everything. This one's slightly different tuning, so I'm wondering if that may have something to do with all this. Not with the pick breaking, but. You know what? My string is a little messed up. I was right. So it did mess up the string a bit. Uh-oh. Yeah, it even knocked it out of tuning. Huh, I've never had a pick break like that, and it really affected my guitar like that. That is so odd. You guys know more about guitars than I do. Let me know in the comments, like, what's going on there. Because I have no clue. But we're just going to move on. Holy crap, I don't even mean to stop in the middle of a song, but that is insane.
Bringing that back and forth? What the? Oh my gosh. I was not prepared for that at all. Sorry, freaking, let's jump right back in. Oh, that one's a hard one. Green line from the north. Yeah, I was about to say. I mean, I got an A. I got over 93%. That's an A. So I call that a good attempt. Was that my best? No. That is one thing I do like about this. It's Rocksmith. Not only you can do this kind of stuff, but also practice individual sections, slow it down, there's plenty of games you can play. There's no multiplayer. I don't even know what you would do for multiplayer. Ubisoft servers have been down for years at this point. But I'm assuming for multiplayer, this is just my guess, but I'm assuming that if, say, my homie has a guitar, I've got a guitar, another friend has a guitar, we can hop on and do different roles. Like, one of us play bass, one of us plays lead, and the other one plays rhythm. That's my only assumption. I was looking at that the other day while I was practicing, and I was really curious. Let me know down below if you guys have had any experience using the Rocksmith multiplayer, and what, like, how good was it? Because I'm imagining, even though Rocksmith is a well-polished game, I'm imagining the multiplayer would have so many problems, especially trying to sync everything up and make sure that everyone's playing, like, the right notes at the right time for their, and also making sure that all the sections line up right. Like, I'm playing the right notes that I'm supposed to at the time that my homie is supposed to be playing his notes, in layman's terms. Alright, that's going to go ahead and wrap things off for today. Thank you guys so very much to those that tuned in. I really appreciate all the love and support that you guys have been showing. Next time we will be back on is for our regular streaming schedule. We're going to be hopping back on Halo 3 on Legendary on Tuesday at noon Pacific Daylight Time. We're going to be finishing that off, and then next week we're going to be starting on Halo 4. So, get hyped for that. Here in just a bit, I'm going to put out a poll for what games we should be playing on Saturdays going forward, because we recently finished up Counterside, so that's gonna be dope. And then on Thursdays, just usual Factorio Death World. Last time we ended up building the rocket silo and a bunch of other stuff. If you guys missed that episode, please feel free to check out the Factorio playlist right over on the channel. That game is super addicting. All right but I will catch you guys later. You beautiful sons of guns, have a great rest of your weekend. And I hope you guys enjoyed. It's your boy Mac Daddy signing out. Peace out, Girl Scouts.